My brothers and sisters, good morning. Welcome everyone to another morning's devotion. I pray that as you tune in this morning, that you will come with two mindsets in this order, that you would come to be a blessing to somebody, and also at the end to receive a blessing from God. I pray that you would lend yourself to this devotional experience, and that as the Lord speak through me, that you will receive a blessing from God that will take you through today. Let us pray. Lord, we want to thank you for your word that you have given unto us. Your word, which is a lamp and light to guide us in our path. Your word, O God, that is supposed to find root in our hearts. Lord, we pray that as we go into this morning's devotion, that you will speak through me, and that the hearts of your people will be blessed. I pray, Almighty God, that you will invest, deposit this word into the hearts of your people. As we seek to talk about love, the greatest gift of all. Mighty God, I thank you this morning that you have demonstrated love. And you have taught us to love one another as Christ loves his church. Speak through me now to bless the hearts of your people. Amen and amen. Good morning again, brethren. I trust that wherever you are this morning, wherever you're tuning in from this morning, that you would have come with an open heart, ready to hear a word from God. Good morning to those who have signed in. I see Sister Dorothy Patterson, Brother Rushin, Sister Caroline, Sister Veronica Brown, Smichael. Welcome. And I know there are others who have signed in. It is my joy. It is my privilege and my pleasure to come here to share in this devotion with you this morning. What is love? The number of definitions. Morning, Brother IT Ellis. Welcome. The number of definitions that is given on a daily basis for love. Some say love is a feeling that you feel in your heart towards somebody or something. Some say love is an emotion. And some people tell that love is a person. Are they wrong? No, they are not. But today, as we examine the theme, love, the greatest gift of all. Many would seek to dispute this topic. And I want to say, if anybody would seek to dispute this topic, they would do so in great futility. Because when you assess and analyze everything that life can give you, and when I say life, I speak of life through people and life through events. When you think of all that life can give you, life cannot give you anything greater than love. So indeed, love is the greatest gift of all. I read for you two verses that I'll use today. And I'll start with St. John 15 and verse 13, which says, Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. That is, to date, that is the best gift that was given in my lifetime. It was given years before my lifetime. The beautiful thing about that gift is that that gift of a man laying down his life for his friends was given out of love. That gift was given out of pure love. A man laying down his life for his friends. It is sad though, that having received that gift, many of us are not treating that gift with the respect and the appreciation that it deserves. Many people still wonder if the gift was real. But you have life, which means that somebody else's life was laid down so that you can have life. So the gift that was given many years ago, Christ laying down his life for us who were not even yet his friends, that was, my friends, the greatest gift of all. I know that there are some people on this platform right now who are married, and you are married to the person you're with because you love them. But in the midst of the fact and the reality that you're married, I am sure that there are days in the marriage when you wondered why you made this decision. Maybe you don't say it with an intention to leave the person, but you would have questioned, could I have done better? Did I do my best? You love the person you're with, you know, don't get me wrong. But sometimes some simple arguments come up. As they say in Jamaica, teeth and tongue meet, and questions are asked. But at the end of the day, you know you love the person. Here's another scenario. Your wife or your husband go ahead and do something, and you get so angry. You get so disappointed at the fact that how could they do such a stupid thing? How could they make that decision without consulting me? How could they do that to make the family look bad? But at the end of the day, you still love the person. But though you love the person, you're angry at some decisions that they make. You're angry at some choices that they make. This man who laid down his life for his friends. There are times when we do dumb things. There are so many times when we do stupid things. But even in the midst of our stupidity, even in the midst of making the wrong decision, the wrong choices, this man, Jesus Christ, still loves us. This man saw ahead of time that we were going to come and make bad decisions, that we were going to come on this earth and fail. This man saw that humanity had failed, but he still came and laid down his life for his friends. That, my friends, is love. That, my friends, is genuine love. Love that cannot be matched by any human love. What is love? I've heard people say that love is a noun. I've heard people say that love is a verb. As a matter of fact, I partner with a ministry from overseas that has a program that they do yearly called Love is a Verb. I believe in both answers. I believe that love is a verb, because love is something that you do. Come on now. Love is something that you do. Love is something that you show. It requires action. And when we go to school, they tell us that verbs are action words. Love is something that you do. You act out love. You live out love. And though we live out love, we cannot outdo love. Can I say that again? And I'm going to say it the right way. Although we are required to live out love, we cannot outlive the love of Christ. Would I die for my friends? Is a question Brother IT is pondering. Jesus Christ laid down his life for you and I, even when we did not accept him or treat him as a friend. My brothers and sisters, this love is a verb. For this love was acted out. This love was acted out by the man Christ Jesus. This love is also a noun, because they tell us that nouns are names of people, places, and things. And if love is a person, then love is Jesus Christ. Love is God. Here, the other verse that I want to use. And I could not talk about love, and I'm not going to beat around the bush. I could not talk about love without talking about St. John 3 and verse 16. The ultimate love letter in the Bible. The ultimate love letter in one verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that you whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. That, my friend, is love being a noun. The greatest gift of all that was given to mankind is Jesus Christ being given to the world. Oh, what a love. Oh, what a love. He did not just come, and I want you to stay with me for this last couple of minutes. Because the Spirit of God is depositing some things in me now that I want you to hear. That Jesus Christ did not just come and die on the cross. If that was the case, then Jesus' sacrifice would have been unfair. Okay, so let me allow that to sink in for a while, because some people might be disappointing with me now, or some people might be pondering if Rev going mad. But if Jesus Christ did only come and went straight to the cross and die, then that sacrifice would not be fear. Jesus came, and in the love that he is, he came and he lived out the experiences of mankind. Glory to God. He came and he lived out the experiences of mankind. He did not only live out the experiences of mankind, he suffered the sufferings of mankind. He went through the hardships of mankind. He never had a house. He never had a bed to lay his head. There were days when he went hungry. He had to experience what mankind experienced. And then, he, having experienced the life of mankind, having gone through the sufferings of mankind, having done all that mankind do, he then did the ultimate. He laid down his life for his friends. My brothers and sisters, St. John 3 and verse 16, which, as I said, is the ultimate love letter in Scripture. For God so loved the world. He saw the conditions of the world. And he so loved the world. That's the scope of his love. The world. It means that nobody is exempted. Nobody is left out. Nobody is exempted from his love. The scope of his love is the world. For God so loved the world. And then there's the hope of his love. What's the hope of his love? That he send his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him, irrespective of who you are, irrespective of where you are, there is hope for you in the love of Jesus Christ. There is hope for you because if you believe in his love, if you believe in this love, the known Jesus Christ, if you believe in the person of this love, there is hope, my friends, for you. Whosoever believeth in him, whether you're black, white, brilliant, dunce, short, fat, it doesn't matter your family lineage. Whosoever believeth in him. So there's a hope and there's a scope of his love. Jesus Christ, the living love, went to the cross and died for your sins and mine. And he has made it open so that you know and I can experience love, the greatest gift of all. And so we looked at love, the verb, and we looked at love, the noun. As I close this morning, I want to invite you to appreciate love, the lifestyle. Jesus Christ has left us to go on to glory to prepare a place for you and I. Upon leaving, he prayed in St. John 16 and 17. He prayed for his disciples. He prayed for those who would get saved. And he prayed for those who are saved. Having lived out love, coming into this earth as love humanified. I know that's not a word, but work with it. As love humanified. Now he has gone unto glory. And he has left you and I to know, demonstrate his love. I pray that as you go through your daily walk, that as the song says, and they'll know we are Christians by our love. May we demonstrate love. May we show love to every person that we experience. May we show love to every person that we encounter on a daily basis. May we show love. May we be love in human form. And Brother Aite, I hope I don't correct me. Because I love my word. Love humanified. I'm going to put a copyright on that word. But I'm saying to you, as we go through this life, as we walk through this life daily, let us demonstrate the love of Christ, the ultimate love of God, the greatest gift of all. You and I now have a responsibility to demonstrate this love as we go. I agree that there are going to be those who are hard to love. I will agree that there are those who we just cannot, and it just going to pain us to love them. But every time it gets hard to love them. Let us remember how hard it was for God. But even though it would have been hard because we were sinners, while we were yet sinners, Jesus died for us. So my brothers and my sisters, remember the word to you this morning. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man to lay down his life for his friends. And remember that God so loved the world, you and me, that he gave his only begotten Son, hallelujah, that whosoever, the hope of his love, whosoever, Brother IT, Sister Michelle, Sister Carlene, Brother Roshane, Rev, Sister Veronica, that whosoever believes in him, love humanified, will not perish, should not perish, but have everlasting life. I thank God this morning that love is still the greatest gift of all. Let us pray. We thank you, God, that you have demonstrated to us your love. I thank you, Lord, that you came and you personified, or humanified as the new word is, what love is. I thank you that in you we can see that love is a verb, because you showed love, you lived out love. And in you we can see that love is a noun, because Jesus Christ is love. So Lord, as children of God, as God's hands and feet, and as God's body in this earth, may we on a daily basis demonstrate love, the greatest gift of all. I pray that you will continue to have your way in and through us. Continue to guide us, continue to protect us, continue to strengthen us, oh God, that we can show love to our family members, show love to our friends, that we will continue to show love to those who are hard to love, always remembering that it was love that led you to the cross. Help us, God, to always remember that it was love why you died. Always remember that it was love, Lord Jesus. It was because of love that you went to the cross and died for my sins, for our sins, for the sins of the world. Thank you, God, that your love, the scope of your love, is endless and unlimited. Thank you, Lord, that there is hope in your love for whosoever will. As we go about our day today, let us be the love story that you want us to be. And let somebody experience love through us. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. My brothers and sisters, friends, I pray God's blessing upon you. May you find in this word an anointing that can carry you throughout the day, as we await another word come tomorrow from the Lord's minister, who will come tomorrow and share with us. God bless you. Have a lovely day. Have a lovely day. Remember who you are. You are love, because God and God's blessed Holy Spirit resides in you. And because of that, we can demonstrate love. Let us be love humanified. God bless you. Amen and amen. God bless you, Rev. God bless you, sir. Thanks again for the opportunity to share with your congregation and your friends. God bless you. Hallelujah. As we go now, God, my friends, the Lord bless you and keep you and make his face to shine upon you. Have an awesome day. Wherever you are this morning, the presence of God be with you. Make him welcome in your lives and in your circle. God bless you and I love you. Amen and amen.